Lighter and more comfortable than before, this is the New Balance 996 V4. New Balance's top-of-the-line shoe for lightweight support gets updated with an all-new Hyponit upper, offering flexibility and support. The midsole has been filled with a full-length fuel cell foam to soften up the ride while maintaining ultimate court feel. A top-loaded shank provides torsional stability without weighing it down, while the Endurance rubber outsole provides superior traction and durability, making this one of the lightest shoes to be backed by a 6-month outsole guarantee. First up on the review, we have Mark. Now, for someone that relies a lot on their court coverage while they're playing, how did the lightweight support of the 996 V4 work for you?
I really enjoyed this update, enjoyed the play test. The ride in the shoe overall was great. Towards the end of my editorial, I'll say what I was gonna be a little nitpicky about, but overall, underfoot, overfoot, around my foot, this is a very comfort-oriented shoe. And I'm surprised New Balance has kind of been leaning towards making their shoes a little bit lighter. That always concerns me. You shave off a little weight, you're gonna be sacrificing some support, maybe comfort and durability. They did a wonderful job. I still feel like the shoe clings to my foot, allows me to move around the court the way I want to, feeling very safe. It is definitely softer than the version 3, so maybe this is a little bit of a hurdle of convincing the other players who have tried that shoe and maybe didn't love it, that this is an entirely retooled, reworked shoe. Also, you know, there's some people that still call in about the Vapor 9.5 Tour. I would definitely say there's some styling and construction cues that are similar, so this would be a great alternative to that as well. Overall, for a lightweight tennis shoe game day, this is a top-notch, top-shelf offering.
Next up on the review, we have Jay. Now, you have a wider foot type, so maybe you can talk about the width version you went with on this shoe and how you liked it overall.
Yeah, I'll talk about the comfort because that's the first thing I noticed when I slipped my foot into these, was just how comfortable they were. I did go with the D width, but that wasn't an issue because of that knit upper. It stretched a little bit to accommodate my foot type. And I'd say that the cushioning was great for walking around in, but once I got it on court, I did notice that it was more toward the minimal side. I would have preferred a little bit more cushioning, especially in the heel, but it did provide that nice low to the ground ride that I typically like in my shoes. I think support and stability are good, not great. Again, I would like a little bit more lateral support and stability for when I'm planting and changing direction there. But overall, I'd say this is a very comfortable shoe. And if you're a player that likes a very sticky outsole, then you'll like these because this definitely has more grip than give. But yeah, overall, very comfortable shoe. If you like a more minimal lightweight shoe, then this is a great offering.
Next up, we have Chris. You have a more narrow foot type, and I know that you also tend to like a shoe that's more minimalistic, low to the ground. What'd you think of this update of the 996?
Yeah, this one, it really broke in quickly. It's super soft and plush feeling in the uppers. They wrap your feet nicely. I was able to get a secure enough fit for my narrow feet, laced it tightly. I used the very last eyelet too to help lock in my ankles, which I found really helped when I was out there moving around on the court, and the breathability I thought was really good. Kept my feet nice and cool, and I felt well ventilated throughout. I'd like a little bit more cushioning out of this one. I do like to be low to the ground, but mostly in the forefoot. And in this one, I felt like the heel cushioning was lacking for me. And when I was coming down, especially I noticed it on my left foot for some reason, but when I would come down hard on my heel, transitioning more towards the backhand side, I was bruising my heel, and it happened throughout the playtest for me. I had like 2 or 3 instances where that bugged me and kind of made me want to wear a different pair of shoes the next few times I hit in them. But like I said, no break-in. The traction is there. There's a very sticky outsole, so I could cut aggressively. I'd like maybe a little bit more stiffness in the upper. I could get rid of some of that like flex and comfort and get a little bit more support and stability out of them. But it is a very lightweight, fast-feeling shoe, and if that's what you're looking for, it's a good option.
I was also on the playtest for this 996 V4 from New Balance. And first thing I noticed when I put these shoes on, they had a very contoured fit, wrapped around my feet, and provided like a very glove-like support for me. So I thought the way they fit my foot was great. They definitely are low to the ground, very kind of minimal feel. I did also notice that the fuel cell that's injected into the midsole did provide a nice squishy type of cushioning, maybe almost a little too soft. And I can see where Chris was talking about getting a little bit of heel pain, because there was a few times on court where I felt like I bottomed out the cushioning and kind of went through it straight to the court. But definitely a flexible option. I felt very fast. Low to the ground. For me, I would have definitely liked a little bit more rigidity to the shoe, especially like in the midfoot area, shank-wise. I like a little bit more torsional stability. I'm a huge fan of the New Balance Fresh Foam Lav. That type of shoe is a little bit more in my wheelhouse. This one's just a little bit too minimal as far as the support goes overall. But if you're looking for something super lightweight, has a durability guarantee, I definitely would put this right up there with like a Babolat Jet Mach 2. Overall, a really good lightweight option, and definitely should check it out. that wraps up this edition of the Shoe Review. For more information on these shoes or anything tennis related, be sure to head to Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, or Tennis Only.